So how do you validate the idea? How do you not waste a lot of time building something that people don't need?
Well, I think that the thing you need to do is just build something. And I realize that sounds a little backwards to the way you asked the question, but you know, you can talk to as many people as you want in life and you'll get some good answers and some bad answers. You know, unless you know how to ask the questions properly, you'll get a lot of bad answers. But really the best way to get people's feedback is to build something. And it might not be the right thing, but as long as it has sort of, you know, the minimal quanta of usable, you know, functionality, it gives people something to interact with. And then you start learning how they use it, what they really want, and you can go from there.
So if I'm an early stage startup and I want to do user research, what do I do? I just build it and release it to the market?
Essentially, yeah. It really is, you know, build something, put it out there, see what happens. Now, the way I would modify that just a little, and this is why it's useful to be your own customer, is that if you're your own customer, right, if you're building this thing for yourself, as you start developing it, you can actually figure out what you need and what you don't need before you release it and see what other people need. If you're building something for someone you don't understand and it's not you, the first piece of feedback you'll get is when you toss it out into the world. And getting people to engage with something is hard enough. Getting people to engage with something they don't actually want or need at all is basically impossible. So if you build something that you need and want, you can get it to the point where it solves your problem. Then you release it and other people will be able to give you feedback and really interact with it, and then you'll just get better faster. You make your iterations faster.
And how do you make sure that you get the right feedback from the right people? How do you make sure that it's not like showing it to your mother and she's saying, hey, that's a great idea?
Yeah. Well, mothers will usually tell you your idea is very nice, unless they actually want you to go back to law school, which is what my mom keeps suggesting. Although she suggested I go get an MBA the other day. I don't know why. You have to pick, right? You have to be smart about it and seek out the people who you think will find what you're doing is useful. Now, some of that is actually picking people by hand, looking at your network and saying, hey, this person is the right demo, the right user type for what I'm building, looks like me or doesn't look like me, but I think I can solve their problem anyway. Let me start with them. The other way is to try to find some sort of distribution early. And there's a bunch of different ways to do that. If you're building a product, Hacker News is an amazing place to go because that's where a lot of people who are interested in technology congregate. They go there, they see what's up, they look at interesting articles. We have something called Show HN, where people just put up new products and they'll get a lot of feedback, a lot of customers, potential customers coming to them. You can use Product Hunt for the same thing. You know, there's a bunch of other things like that that you can use. But really, it's about being relentless. There's a great story that Ben from Pinterest tells, you know, the founder of Pinterest. And when he was starting Pinterest, he didn't think anyone would want to use it. And so he literally went to coffee shops and showed the prototypes of Pinterest to moms that he saw at coffee shops. He said, these are probably going to be my demo. Let me see what they think. And he had them, and he just took notes at coffee shops. And it's that level of drive of just finding people who want to use what you're building that's critical in getting some sort of engagement.